Ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to the season launch 2014 of the Port Adelaide Football Club. We're delighted to have you here. And what about this? How good is this stadium at the moment? It is just stunning what we're going to be playing in this year. And for us, it is a sort of return to home, isn't it? A return to home where we won 20 SANFL grand finals. And so it's terrific to come home to Adelaide Oval. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us, distinguished guests, and also past presidents Greg Bolton, welcome, and Brett Duncanson, who is with us here tonight as well, who under their stewardship, the club built the building blocks to where we are today and to take it on further. So gentlemen, thank you again for all your help in the past and all your current advice too. We've all been on a journey to get here to Adelaide Oval. Many people said we'd never get here, but we did, and it is terrific that the season is starting off. Look, at the start of last season, I was on the record as saying we had to build our club on a number of key pillars, six key pillars. We wanted to be an employer of choice in the football community. We wanted to establish really great core values and culture and retain expert staff. We wanted to take our brand nationally. We wanted to reinforce and indeed maintain our community links and grow them. We wanted to play attractive, exciting, entertaining footy. We wanted to put the fun back into footy. And we also wanted to have an eye on the future and most importantly, really cement the commercialisation of this club. Now, those six pillars are still very much in place in the organisation as we go forward. And I want to give you a bit of an update. I want to report back to you on how we've gone over the last 12 months and the challenges we're setting ourselves over the next 12 months. I think it's really important that we have that we're accountable to you. It's your club, and you need to be kept informed of these things because we know of the enormous trust that you put in us to look after your club. And we want to make sure that you're confident that the club is in the right hands. So if I can, let's just go through some of those pillars and where we're at. First of all, we wanted to be an employer of choice. We've attracted really key staff right across the organisation over the last 12 months. Yes, we lost Richo as our director of coaching to St Kilda, and we're seeing him again tomorrow, and he is always welcome in this club. I got a little narky at the time, not because Alan Richardson was offered a senior coaching role, because we welcome that. It's a reflection of the standing that this club has in the football community, that another club can approach one of our coaches. I was just a bit narky about the timing, that it was so far into our planning for the next year. As a result of some of our grumblings, the AFL has now changed the rules, and there is a deadline now where all coaching appointments have to be made. So that's terrific. So we wish Richo all of the best. On the upside, we landed Sean Hart, a highly respected triple premiership player, Norm Smith medalist with the Brisbane Lions, and most recently an assistant coach at the Gold Coast Suns. Sean has fitted in perfectly to the organisation with values and beliefs that are absolutely aligned with ours. So welcome, Sean. Also, we welcome back to the club our midfield manager, strategist Phil Walsh, who spent five seasons at the West Coast Eagles. Of course, Phil was part of our 2004 Premiership success, considered within the industry as one of the smartest tacticians in the game, and his entry to our coaching box this year is sensational and so highly anticipated. And of course, like Sean, has very similar core values to what we have in the club. And of course, Darren Burgess, our high performance manager, returned to the club at the end of 2012 after having spent time away from Alberton with the Socceroos and Liverpool FC, and significantly last year gained his PhD as well. So it's now Dr. Darren Burgess, and we have to give him a little bow every time we talk to him. But that's the quality of the people that we've always targeted and wanted to attract to this club to be an employer of choice. And that's because we have a number of things. Outstanding player welfare programs. Stewie Cochran in the past and now Marcus Drum do a great job. They genuinely care for families, for players, a very inclusive nature. I loved it last year when Ollie's mum, Jane, did a story for the Herald Sun. Robbo interviewed her and she told the story of the night that Ollie was drafted, and she went home and cried all night because she thought he was going to footy hell, and he ended up going to footy heaven and couldn't be more delighted. So that's the type of thing that we're aiming to do, to have a best practice football program that the best talent in this country want to come and play for. And we've taken a first step. There are many more steps to come. And you'll remember just before Christmas, we had our 5 days of Christmas with five significant re-signings to the club, led by our captain Travis Boak and Schultze and our leadership group, Hamish and the guys. Well, tonight I'm absolutely delighted to announce continuing reflection of our goal to be an employer of choice in the football community, and to announce four re-signings extensions here tonight. The first one, re-signing, finished eighth in our best and fairest last year. He played, can play a variety of roles, is a big part of our future. He has signed for an extra 2 years until the end of 2016. Would you show your appreciation to Cam O'Shea for entrusting his football future with us? Cam, congratulations. Thank you very much, and we look forward to ongoing development of your football career. Also, signing until the end of 2017, a 2009 first round draft selection. He's battled injuries since he's been here, but you saw a little glimpse of his ability against Essendon a couple of weeks ago in the NAB Challenge game. Would you show your appreciation for re-signing until the end of 2017, Jasper Pittard? Our third key cornerstone re-signing that I'm delighted to announce tonight is a bloke who he's a freak as a big bloke. Fifth in last year's best and fairest. The bloke can play anywhere. I forget the game where he took a screamer right down in the back pocket and then kicked the goal about 30 seconds later. He has enormous aerobic stamina, is one of the cornerstones of the team, took our most contested marks in 2013, and I'm delighted he signed for an extra 3 years until the end of 2017. Would you thank Justin Westhoff? Westy's become a bit of a cult hero in this club, hasn't he? Sort of the laconic way that he goes about his footy and just produces remarkable results. And our final signing, re-signing for that we'd like to announce tonight, finished third in the NAB Rising Star Award last year. He won the Gavin Wanganeen Medal as the best under 21 player in 2013. He played all 24 games last year, an incredible effort for a first year player. It made us smile a bit watching the footy show last night, but signing for an extra 2 years, so he will stay in footy heaven till the end of 2016 at least. Would you thank Ollie Wines? No, we're building a foundation. I think we can all sort of feel that we're on the road to something a bit special with this group, and they can too. And we really do thank them for all their support, and also Ken and the coaching staff for building a set of values and a program that is the envy of a lot of AFL clubs around the country. So thank you to the coaches and football department as well for that. Our other pillar, let's continue the accountability, is to play an exciting brand of footy. We promised two things last year. We'd never, ever give up, and we play an exciting brand of footy, and I think you'll agree that this playing group absolutely delivered that. I take you back 12 months ago, and see, we're too poor to actually be able to hire an advertising agency. So Cos Cardone, our Melbourne director, and myself were thinking, what the hell can we promise this year? We started to think about it and said, look, the only thing we can really promise, because you know the previous few years had been a bit disappointing to our members, is that we'd play the Port Adelaide way, that we'd never ever give up. And we went and talked to Ken about it and said, look, this is what we're thinking about. And he said, absolutely. We will never, ever give up. That's part of our ethos. That's part of our value set. And we said, beauty, you're going to be doing the television ad and you're going to be making that promise. And thinking he would go, no, I'm not. He said, terrific, I'll do that. And the entire playing group did it. And they certainly delivered on that. And our members have responded to it. As of today, we are sitting on a record 44,350 members as we push towards 50,000. We haven't even had round one yet. This figure puts us in the top eight for membership rankings in the AFL, top eight. That's a 51% increase in members since 2010. And people want to reconnect with our club and they want to start our journey, and we are welcoming them aboard. And just I'd love to give you a little sneak peek of what our membership ad looks like for this year as well.